Today we are going to discuss about adding the essential SEO tags to our Next.js site. I won't be going into the details of adding it to all the pages, but instead I will show you how to add it to a single post page, as that will give you an idea on how to add it to all the other pages. Currently, if we check the head section of a single post page, you can see that we are outputting the title tag and the meta description. On the other hand, if you take a look at another blog that is properly developed using WordPress, you can see that the head section contains a lot more tags besides the title and meta description. For instance, the Facebook opengraph tags, including the title, description, site name, featured image, etc., as well as the Twitter cards and also the structured data in JSON format. That's within a script tag. It contains all the essential information about that particular post, including the thumbnail image URL, modified date, published date, permanent URL of the page, and so on. This might help search engines to find your page and rank it better. Also, it makes your post look better when shared on social media. The core WordPress installation does not contain all these features, so we have to use an SEO plugin, and I am going with the Yoast SEO plugin, which has over 5 million installations as of now. It offers a lot of additional features such as setting up a custom title and meta description on a per post basis, as well as setting up your social media profiles, setting up a sitemap, etc. And in order to be able to access this SEO data via the GraphQL API, we want to install this extension plugin as well. It integrates Yoast with WP-GraphQL so that we can access this data using GraphQL queries. So let me go to the WP admin and install both the plugins. On the add plugins page, search for Yoast, then install it, then activate Yoast. Okay, Yoast is now installed and activated. Similarly, we want to install the extension as well. So again, on the add plugins page, search for Yoast WP GraphQL and install it. Then activate it. Now both the plugins are activated. On the left side, you can see a new menu item called Yoast SEO. Yoast comes with some first-time configuration settings. Here you can do a bunch of things such as analyzing the site for better SEO optimization, setting up the type of your site, whether it's a person or an organization, setting up the website name and things like that. You can even set a logo image and the other details. You can also set the social media profiles, personal preferences, etc. However, this is not a necessity to start using Yoast. You can access the Yoast widget on individual post editor pages, where you can set the custom title, meta description, open graph tags, Twitter cards, and the schema markup settings. For instance, I am opening this page in the WordPress editor, and on the right side itself, you can see the Yoast widget, where you can set the focus keyword for this post. You can access the same thing at the bottom as well. There also you can set the focus key phrase. Below that you can set the custom SEO title and the meta description. By default, it will be the post title and the post excerpt respectively. With this, you can set the post title and the SEO title separately. For instance, here I want to replace the site name in the title with something else. Based on the topic of this post, let it be how to choose a hiking backpack, followed by the top things to consider. Okay, that's the SEO title. Likewise, I can also enter a custom meta description, which can be different from the post excerpt. You can also notice the word count progress bar changing in color as I type in the field. The color changes from orange to green when the length becomes optimum. The color is still orange, which means the length is not yet optimum, so I am adding a few more words. And now the color has changed to green, which is a good indicator. Once you are satisfied, click update. Besides that, there are a few more tabs such as the social tab, where you can set the custom image, title and description for both Facebook and Twitter. However, it's not a necessity to fill it up. the default featured image, title and description will be picked up and used for Facebook and Twitter. Apart from that, in the schema tab, you can set the page type and the article type. The default values are good enough. Okay, I think that's enough for this post. Now it's time to go back to the Next.js site and implement it there. So here is the Next.js code opened in the editor. Now I am inside the single post route file post-slug.js. And I want to add the SEO tags to the head section. But before that, we want to fetch that. So let me create a GraphQL query for that. So create a new file inside the lib directory called seo.js, where I can define a function to fetch the SEO tags for a particular post. First of all, import the GraphQL request function, then define the function getSEO, which has two parameters, the page type, the default value is post, and also the slug of the current post or page. And within that, let's define the query constant. And as always, we want to build the query from the WordPress admin GraphIQL IDE. So go to WP admin and open GraphIQL IDE. Since we have already enabled the Yoast extension for GraphQL, you can find a section called SEO. We are fetching the data for a single post. So set the ID and ID type values. Set the ID to the slug of this post. Then go to the SEO section and expand it. Now let's select the fields we want to fetch. We want the title and the meta description. So check title, then meta description. And in addition to that, we also want to fetch the structured data. That is a schema markup in raw format. Run the query and this is how the result will look like. It's the bare minimum we require, but in addition to that, we can also select the open graph tags. Although from Facebook, open graph is also supported by other social media sites like Twitter and LinkedIn. So adding them can make your post look eye-catching when shared on social media sites, because it can add a custom thumbnail image, title and a description. So here I am selecting the open graph title and open graph description, then open graph URL. Then going to open graph image, we want the media item URL. Here note that the open graph title, description and image will be the same as the SEO title, meta description and featured image, unless it's set separately from the Yoast settings area. Okay, next we want the open graph type. That is the type of the page we are sharing. For a blog post, it will be article. Then we may also add the open graph site name. Okay, I think that's enough. Run the query and this is how the result looks like. Here is the title, meta description, followed by a long schema markup. And the open graph tags. Okay, name the query as getSEO and copy it. Then in the editor, paste it as the query property. Now replace the slug with the slug variable. Also replace post with the page type variable so that we can reuse it for WordPress pages as well. Yeah, that's our query. Now it's time to send the query as a GraphQL request. So define a constant called getSEO and call the GraphQL request function and pass the query. Then from that data, extract the SEO portion. Let's take a look at the structure of the data. This is how it goes, data.post.SEO. So we can access it like this. Finally, return the constant SEO data. Now going to the single post route file, post-slug.js, import the getSEO function from lib/SEO. Now we are ready to call that function within getStaticProps, just like we did for the comments. So constant SEO data equals call the function getSEO and pass the arguments. The first argument is the string post. Second argument is the URL path, params.postslug. Then return the SEO data as a prop. Also add that to the argument list of the function post. Next, we want to add it to the head section of the page. Currently, we are displaying the title and the meta description. The title is set to the post heading while the meta description is displaying the post excerpt. Replace them with our custom SEO title and the meta description. So first we are adding the title tag and the content is seodata.title. We can also add the key attribute. The key attribute is not compulsory, but adding it can avoid potential duplicates. Similarly, add the meta description also. Meta name equals description, content equals seodata.metadisc. Before continuing, let's take a look at the page to see if they are being displayed correctly or not. There is an error, but when I reloaded the page, the error is gone and we can see the new title and description. So it's working. Next, we want to add each of the open graph tags also. So start by adding a meta tag, then set the property attribute. The first one is open graph title, OG colon title, and the content is variable seodata.opengraphtitle. Now let me copy and paste it for the other tags as well. The second one is OG description, and the content is seodata.opengraphdescription. The third one is the OG URL, which is the URL of the current post. The fourth one is OG image. For that, we want the media item URL. OpenGraphImage.mediaItemURL. Following that, we want to add the open graph type. Its value will be article. Then comes the locale. We want to set the language locale. It's going to be the same for all the posts, so there is no need to fetch it from the backend. So let me skip that for now. Then the open graph site name. It's also same for all the pages. Finally, we want to add the schema markup within a script tag. Add a script tag and then set the type attribute to application/ld+json. Then set the script's inner HTML using the dangerously set inner HTML attribute. Set the value to schema.raw. seodata.schema.raw. Okay, I think that's enough. Checking in the web page, the tags are already showing up correctly. Yeah, I want to change the OG locale. Set it to something like ENIN. Let's expand the script tag. And this is how the schema markup looks like. So that's how you add the essential SEO tags to a Next.js site powered by WordPress. As a final step, we may also verify the schema markup. So open the schema validator website. We are running the site on localhost, so the page is not publicly available. So we want to copy the whole source code and paste it in the validator. Run test and yeah, it's working. There are no errors or warnings. And the validator could successfully identify all the data we included in the schema markup. Here is the image. By the way, there is a small correction required for the URL. It's still showing up the WordPress URL. We want to change it to the Next.js frontend URL. While for the thumbnail image, it's okay to use the WordPress URL. So going back to the editor, we want to replace the WordPress URL with the frontend Next.js URL. Let's perform a replace operation for the schema markup. So define a new variable called JSON schema, then call the replace function upon the schema. Here I am going to use a rejects function to find all the occurrences of wp.abhinavar.com and replace only the page URLs, not the image URLs. So let's add a rejects condition. followed by the string we want to replace. That is, if wp.abhinavar.com is not immediately followed by wp-content/uploads, that is, if it's an image, don't replace. The slash g denotes find all the occurrences. Okay, and the string to be replaced with is the URL of the frontend site, that is coolnomad.abhinavar.com/blog. Okay, I hope that will do the trick. So replace that with JSON schema. Similarly, we want to replace the open graph URL as well. Since it's a one-time replace, there is no need for the rejects. So variable OG URL equals SEO data dot open graph URL dot replace. Replace wp.abhinavar.com with coolnomad.abhinavar.com/blog. Replace that here as well. Now let's check if it's working or not. Reload the source code. Yeah, here we can see the replaced URLs. So it's working. The OG URL meta tag is also being displayed correctly with the newly replaced URL. Now we want to revalidate the schema markup. So copying the source code and pasting it in the validator. Then run the test. Yeah, the page URL is changed while the thumbnail URL is preserved. Okay, I hope you found this video useful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Okay, this video is probably going to be the last video in this current series. So if you want me to make more videos about Next.js and Headless WordPress, you can comment the ideas below.